Hello everybody and welcome back to the Moshix mainframe channel. This is Moshix and today we're going to be looking at how to produce beautiful gorgeous printouts from your Hercules mainframe. But before we get there, I would like to make a service request or service announcement or just reaching out to all of you viewers out there and ask if there's anybody who could spare for maybe a week or two a login for me on a ZOS 2.2 or 2.3 system with a 64-bit PL1 or COBOL compiler. I would like to produce a video on 64-bit COBOL and the COBOL compiler by IBM. The compiler just came out recently in the last year or so, or year and a half, and I've never worked with a 64-bit compiler on ZOS, and so I would like to play with it a little bit and produce a video for the viewers out here. I don't need to be an administrator, just a very simple programmer. Login, TSO login would be great. Having said that, if you have such a login, please reach out to me by replying in the comment section below this video or by sending me an email at moshix@gmail.com. So let's go, and thank you again. Let's go to our topic for today, which is printing from within Hercules. And so this is not strictly related to MVS 3.8 per se. We can obviously print out from any operating system that can run on top of Hercules. But the operating system I'm going to be focusing on today is going to be MVS 3.8. Maybe I'll make a different one for VM 370. I did print out from VM 370 in the past. I just don't remember right now what the command sequence is within VM, within CMS. I'm not very premium with VM 370. I can just basically start, guess, and compile very simple jobs. But I'll maybe produce a video about that. So when you want to print out from MVS 3.8 or from Hercules, obviously, we can do two things. We can, for instance, first of all, we need to know what kind of a message class goes to the printer. In TK4, message class A will go to printer, this printer here, zero. Let me show you. So printer 00E is message class A. Message class B goes to the 3211 printer, if I'm not mistaken. And I usually print, if I really need to print out, I usually use message class A, just my own personal convention. So I know it's always printer 00E, which in a TK4 is defined as a file. So print in the print directory, PRT slash file name is PRT00E. .txt. So the easy way is just, sorry for the mess on the screen here. We go to PRT and then let's more PRT0E. I also need to make the screen here quite a bit bigger. I have a very big font here on my monitor. Excuse me, so that you viewers on smaller devices can see what's going on the screen. And so that's one way to print it. And if I wanted to print from here, I could just I could print the whole file, right? And if I did that, it would go on my printer. But since I have quite a bit of stuff here, it will print in endlessly. I have, how much is that? 88 megabytes of printout on this file here. It's getting quite big. So that's one way to do it, and I think most of you know this. In Windows, we just click on it and open it. And so that works, obviously. Where is my, here is my Hercules. And that works fine. Now, the other way to print it is to produce beautiful, gorgeous printouts. And to do that, there are several ways to do that. The first, you know, obviously the best way to do it is first produce a PDF so that you can print it on any printer. and have it come out nice, because if you print it out from on a character level as a character file, it will not come out very nice. I'm telling you from experience, so I wouldn't play with that too much. You want to first turn it into a PDF. If you want to turn it into a PDF, there are several ways to do this. There is a command called nscript. Where is it? There is a command here. This is for LaTeX. There's some commands here which I've used in the past, and they look kind of okay. I have to say that I was never really fully happy. Here's one, text to PDF. With the output, so text to PDF is a command. You may have to install it with apt install if you're using a Debian-based Linux version. And there's some Windows-based utilities that you can download that will create. But the problem with this approach is that, first of all, it's not that beautiful, and then you would have to put in a very long command line, which you can, into the definition of the printer here. So Hercules allows you to script everything that goes into the printer, for instance. So it can accept input or output into this file and convert it. So you can put in a full Linux command in the definition of the file, of the printer. That works, that I've done in the past. But there's one more problem with that, is then you would have to still kind of try to understand what is the separation between print jobs, and then make a print, produce a PDF for each print job. And there are some utilities out there, one by a community member who produced a print utility, and it kind of works okay. But I think the best output result I have had was with this utility, which is very, it's just amazing. This is the website of Fish. Fish is the, I would say, the overall maintainer for the Hercules software. He's the lead developer. Very, very smart person. He has this company called Software Development Labs, and he has a couple of utilities which he sells here. One is this GUI, which allows you to run Hercules from a Windows user interface, and it's basically this window that we have here will be reflecting this user interface. You can set a load addresses like it was a 360 mainframe back in the 60s. I've never bought it because I don't need a user interface to start Hercules, because I do everything on Linux anyway. And so that's one thing he sells. The other thing he sells is he has a channel-to-channel adapter for Windows, so you can get out to the, you can connect your Hercules to the network. And I never tried this software either. Then he sells utilities that let you look at tape images, which is probably useful, but I've never bought that either. But I did buy this amazing utility, HercPrint. HercPrint is a remote Hercules print spooler. It is designed to receive text output from a Hercules line printer and create a PDF, RTF, HTML text file on the Windows system. Now, this is something that I do recommend if you're doing serious work on Hercules that you buy. I think it's only like $15, yeah, $14.95. It's an amazing utility. You install it very easily, and then you can connect it to the Hercules instance, and every time you print to the printer that you want to be printing on, it will receive this output and create a beautiful PDF, and I'll show you today how to use that. So once you purchase it, it will send you a download link. You download it, install it, all standard Linux, Windows stuff here, so you don't need to explain that. And then you launch it. And once you launch it, that's how it looks. You have this utility here, HercPrint, MVS308, and you can launch several instances. So you could have one instance for each printer you have on your Hercules. Or if you run several Hercules instances in your network, you can have one for each Hercules instance, which is what I do. And then you give this a printer ID. I'm going to give it the IP of my printer here and do this again. And then it wants the port number, and we get to that in a second. And then it needs a control file. So there are control files which you can create your own, which what they do is they try to understand what is a print job, where does it start and what does it end, what are the separator lines, so that for each job output you would have a different file, a different PDF in your output directory. So for, and it has several definitions. It has even one for ZOS, which I haven't tried yet, but the one, and I think some even for MVS 3.8, for VM 370, but the one that I use is MVS 38J 33 Linux. That's the one you want to use for JS2. That's a control file, and then you give it a spool directory, which in this case I call YouTube output. And so this is the first part. Then the second tab allows you to configure how you want the output to look like. I like to have blue lines, so I always choose default blue. I don't like the feeder holes, and we will see soon what this all means. And then the font name I wouldn't change. One thing that I have done on my system is I actually went out and bought the 1403 vintage font from a person who produces these fonts. You can find them out on the internet. It was actually quite expensive. I think it was about $100 for these fonts. They're scalable fonts. You can go with the default that it tells you, but in my case I will use a 1403 vintage fonts, and I will show you in detail soon how this all looks like. So this is how I want it to look like, compressed, no feeder fold, and I want to embed the font. That is quite important because, for instance, the 1403 vintage font is not present on 99.999% of all Windows computers out there. So what I do is I embed the font definition in the PDF so that people can open it and they will look at the same font that I'm looking at on my screen. So embedding here is very important. So how do we connect this to Hercules? So to do this, the normal Hercules configuration file has this definition in TK4, print directory, print 00E, print FCB, and this kind of definition. Now we want to change that to something else. How do we change that? Remember, this is unit address 000E. So we switch to command mode on Hercules, and then we write device init 00E. So because this is the IP of this computer that where Hercules is running. Or you could also just do localhost, and then I give it this kind of port because that's the same port number as the model number of the printer. And then the command suck dev. I don't remember what dev means anymore, but you need to put that in. If you put this in, it says device initialized, and the printer is now really just a listener. It creates a listener so that something can connect to it. Localhost 1403 sockdev. And unfortunately, Hercules continues to print the previous definition back here, so this has nothing to do with the new definition. It's just an error that's been around in Hercules forever. I've variously reported this. But this is what Hercules is listening on, what's operating on right now. So now that we have this on, we can go back to our Hercules print definition and connect it. And it's not connecting. Why is that? Disconnect. I guess we do have to find 52, the IP address. So let's do it like this. 3 sock dev. Okay, let's try again now. Yeah, it's connected, and once it connects, it goes into the taskbar here, so it will disappear. And this is important, folks, because a lot of people have asked me, why does it disappear? It's still here. If you want to look at it, you're just pressing it with the right mouse click and press and show, and it's here and it's connected. and everything is exactly as we wanted it. So it's still running. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna launch a job that will print to message class A, and then it should come out in this folder here. So let's keep this down here. And if you will be able to see, once I launch the output, that the job and then create output, you will see here, of course, an MVS message that it's printing out something. And you'll also see it in this dialogue here of, where is it? Here it is. You'll also see here that it's producing output. It says here connected and receiving output. Okay, so let's try this. Just keep an eye here. Let me keep an eye here, and I'll go and produce an output, and then you should also be able to see it here in this folder here. So let's go to something that produces some nice output. JCL lib. The PL1. I like the PL1 compiler output a lot. And so this is Herc 01PL YouTube print out print video. Oops, I have a spellers here. Bear with me, please. Okay, let's make this also uppercase. And that's it. I don't like all this. So let's get some output going and let's see how beautiful this looks. And again, keep an eye here, and keep an eye here, and keep an eye here, if you bear with me. So submit, receiving, and here it is. And now I can open this. Acrobat. Has Adobe starts to create real painful software lately. I can barely stand it. I just want to print a PDF viewer. I don't want a whole operating system installed on my computer. But here's the output. It's beautiful. So this is how output used to look back in the days. It's blue stripe paper, Herc. We have the name of the job number, obviously, you know all this. And Herc YouTube print video. I could also put in room and then room number, but no need. And then this is how it looks. I can make this a little bigger for you. Now, where do the font that I bought, where does it show? Well, if you remember the 1403 font, one thing that is easy to remember is that the T was like this. It was just a bar, long bar, and then an horizontal bar, a vertical and horizontal bar. And that's how this is how I remember the font back in the days of the 1403 printer, which I worked with in the 80s. Whenever I was compiling a job and I would get the output later on, it was printed on a 1403 printer, and that's how the chain that was with the font on the printer, that's how it looked like. I just like it. And so here we have the whole output. Look how beautiful this is. I think one of the most rewarding thing about working with Hercules is just having beautiful, beautiful output. And this is what this utility by Fish and or through his company Software Development Labs, what he produces. We can also try something else. Let's go get another job. And in the meantime, maybe we change it to green stripe, because most people would have worked with green stripe. Back when I worked with the mainframe in the military, we had blue stripe, but let's make it green. Or anything really. Press OK, and of course it disappears back here. You have to show, bring it back up here again. Let's get a COBOL output. Herc 01 COBOL. And here again. Okay, message class A, that's the message class that goes to this printer. And you will see appearing here as job 400 probably. Before I do that, I want to eliminate this thing here. It's a little eyesore. And you will also see it again appear here with the name of the description here. That's the beautiful thing. It is able to extract the name that you gave the job, the description gave the job, and give this as a file name to your PDF file. So that's the beauty of this utility. Okay, let's launch it and then keep an eye again here. It will say receiving. We'll see job 400 here, receiving, and then you'll see it in here. Let's launch it. Receiving. Boom, here it is. And now we have it. What's wrong now? There was an error processing the page. I don't know why it's saying this. You could also open it with the browser. Open with Google Chrome. Yeah. So this is ridiculous. Adobe is not able to open their own format, whereas Google Chrome is able. But here, this is how it looks like. Beautiful green striped paper. And you can print this on a printer. If you have color print, it will come out very nice, very readable. And here's the output. We can also do holes, print feeder holes. So we go here, feeder holes, and resubmit the same job again, this time with feeder holes. And let's open it again with the browser. And now it looks exactly like it used to look back in the days with feeder holes and the separation line here. This is very much how I remember output looking back in the 80s. I mean, this is, and again, this is the, you see it in the T. If you can see this on your screen, the T here is a 1403 print chain font. I love this font very much. Let's also do something else. Let's see how fast this printer utility is by Fish. If you remember, we have the language testing tool by Walter Mueller. And I have it here. Let's go to jobs and let's do make. Produce all the, okay, so let's Hercules launch all the COBOL jobs, and they are all in class A, so that should fire up quite a few of this. It will prepare quite a few jobs, and they will, let's see how fast it's able to produce them here. Let's have the utility show. So now we're not going to be using this terminal session. So let's put it here. And let's make this folder view a little better. Okay. And let's launch this and let's see how it does. Okay. You can, so, okay, this already arrived. Okay, there was only one. So let's launch all of them. And let's see what comes out. Receiving. Well, that was fast. Did you see that? My mainframe is not working at 120 MIPS. And wow, there's a lot of jobs arriving here in real time. So it is quite fast. It's receiving nonstop. You see here, receiving, and I have this sorted by, yeah, so it's doing it now in reverse order, and I'm running at 215 MIPS, 250 MIPS, 290 MIPS, amazing. I mean, this would have been a giant mainframe just 15 years ago. All right, okay, so it's working hard and it's able to keep up. As you can see here, every time the printer is being addressed, it turns yellow here. Keep an eye on here. every time it prints out something, the unit right now turns yellow. And when it turns yellow, it means it's passing it on to the listener, and the listener is attached to this utility on my computer. And these two computers are not the same computers, they're different computers, because this is running inside a virtual machine. As you can see here, it's producing quite a few. Let's open one of them. Open, let's see. Yeah, Adobe. I'm starting to think that Adobe has peaked and is already. It should probably be broken up into smaller companies, because they keep on tripping over themselves. But look how beautiful this is. Okay, this is the test job that does the instruction timing. These are register instructions. So that's what this job does. But we're looking at the output here. This is not about what the job does, just the quality of the output. And this is quite a few pages. I mean, there must be easily be by now 10,000, 20,000 pages in here. So it's keeping up beautifully. It's still perceiving here and producing the output. Oh, 325 MIPS. So you can check here the fastest it's been running by typing max rates. And wow, so the fastest this has been is 494 MIPS and 6,200 IOs per second. I mean, this was a truly giant mainframe just 15 years ago, even just 10 years ago. This kind of shows you, and this is emulated, it kind of shows you how fast the Intel CPUs are compared to mainframes. The Intel CPUs are probably just as fast as real mainframe CPUs these days. The speed advantage is gone that mainframes had. So this is it. This is how it works. This will work the same with VM370 and with DOS VSE. I've tried it in the past. I know it also worked with ZOS, but I have no printer out in the internet I can connect with which runs ZOS. I haven't tried that out yet, but I'm told it works. And it's $14.95, very well spent if you like mainframe stuff. I hope that Fish will appreciate this shameless advertising I'm doing for a software, but it is very good software and it deserves to be mentioned in my videos. I use it very extensively and I like it a lot. I do suggest you buy it and install it and enjoy the beautiful output. This is all for today. Again, if you can spare me a login on a ZOS 2.3 system so I can play with 64-bit compilers for a little bit, I would appreciate it very much. Please do subscribe to my channel so you can get notifications of future videos. If you like this particular video, please press the thumbs up button. And thank you very much. Goodbye.